up, ladies and gentlemen? It is your boy, Anklespankin here, playing Kalista with her... Wow, this skin is actually really cool. I haven't seen it in-game yet. But, whoa, this looks so cool. Alright, this is the Blood Moon Kalista skin, I believe. And I have played this champion one time. Hold on, let me go ahead and just oath sworn Sebastien. Sebastien! Sebastien! Let me six you! Let me six you. Oh my goodness. Oh, what are we waiting for? Use the speed boost first. Oh, right. He's right. He is right. I always figured there's a speed boost out of the base. Now do it. Got it. The Oath Sworn Bond. Haha. Hey. Uh-oh. He is going to be coming over here, and this will be bam. Wait. Will it be a kill? Up. No, that's not going to be a kill. Wait. Boom. Boom. There's two kills. Let's go ahead and keep this. Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Yeah. No. Fuck. Okay. This is good. This is great, guys. I get to start lane with a pickaxe. And a potion. Holy fucking shit. The 3-1. Oh, Kalista. Let's do this, boys. Oh my god. That pickaxe. Start. Oh my god. Oh god, guys. I am not... I am puzzled right now. I do apologize, guys. I did not expect that to happen, especially not the way it did. I was trying to use Kalista mechanics to get some kills and not die, and I almost didn't die, but I got 3 kills. So lane is suddenly going to be a lot more fun now. Anyways, oh fuck, dude, I am so bad at CS with this champion. I don't know how to actually cancel an auto, to be honest. I only know how to kind of leap everywhere. So let's go ahead and just trade a little bit. Or miss CS. Oh, there we go. Got a little trade. Anyways, one thing, like, there are lots of things about Kalista. She is confusing as shit at first. If you guys want to play her, god damn it. If you guys want to play her, make sure you do it in a normal game first, or not either a normal or even a bot game, because as you guys can see, I am actually missing some CS even though it's totally free, just due to the fact that it's so weird. Like, it's legitimately so odd to sit here and try to CS, because you get this auto attack delay that kind of goes away as you get more attack speed, but if you move when you auto, your character actually jumps into the direction that you clicked. So Kalista is very unique and very fun. But oh, that poke! Let's go ahead and get some E off in here. Oh, dropping these autos going to out trade them. Bam! Oh, you can't hit this, son. And that will be a very good trade for us, me and Sebastien down here. And let's see, 21 CS, not bad, not bad. I don't know if they have summoners, so I'm not really trying to go super ham or super risky right now, so I'm just gonna chill, and we'll see how this lane goes. Let me explain Kalista's skills to you guys real fast. Her Q is actually, as you guys can see, it's just this piercing, well, it's only piercing if it kills the target, but it's this big spear that you just chuck at people, and it does some damage and puts a stack of your E into them if you have it leveled. And what your E does is it's an infinitely stacking buff on them, or debuff on them, I guess, that, oh, shit. Yeah, that'll be a kill! Boom! Boom! Double kill! Hopping around like it's nothing. And, wow. Great job. As you guys can see, there is not a whole lot to it. Oh, shit. Shit. Oh god, oh god, okay. Okay. We got this. Yeah, son! That'll be... Wow, that was some of the easiest killing I've ever done. All right. 6-1-0 Kalista, and I have a BF sword and pickaxe 5 minutes into the game. Wow. BF done. Holy shit. Okay. Oh my god. What was I trying to... Kalista's skills. Her Q, Pierce, it throws the big spirit people. If it kills it, it goes straight through it and does damage to people behind it until it doesn't kill it. And then you can use your E and rip the spears out from your target and deal additional damage to them, which increases by percentage on how many hits you have inside them, which at level 1 is 25% additional damage per spear that you actually have inside them. So now we are Kalista with a BF sword. And... Oh! Whoa! That damage... I'm gonna actually flash out. Because I don't trust anything right now. Looks like Sebastien's coming in. Let's go ahead and get this. Boom! Boom! And boom! Wait! Yeah! There's one kill! And Thresh actually killed me. But... Sebastien, actually, I don't know if Sebastien can get this. Oh, wait, he totally can, maybe? Oh, the hook is not going to land. Scion coming in, and boom. That'll be a kill right there. Easy peasy, 7-2-1 now. Great job by those two. And I'm just going to grab my boots now. I did misplay that. I took a lot more damage than I should have before that fight actually started. I was just getting really cocky, but that happens. Anyways, her W is called Sentinel. And what it does is... See, as you guys can see, it's a very, very, very long range, okay? It's a very, very long range. And what it does is it actually sits there and lets me essentially have this beast-ass ward that just laps back and forth for a while. For a very long while. God, that damage. What do you know about this? Anyways, on top of that, if it sees a champion, it deals additional damage and boom! Did I hit her? I don't know if I hit her. But it deals additional damage. And then, or not deals damage. I'm sorry, guys. I'm getting so puzzled. I'm trying to focus on playing because she's a very complex champion to play in lane. But, whoop. Okay, he's not going to get speared. But it reveals the champion for 4 seconds that it sees. And then it will also, like, scream at you. And then the other part of the W is actually when you have Oath Sworn on. And your Oath Sworn is this line right here, this tether, that thing I did with Sebastien at the beginning of the game where I threw my item in my 6-slot at him. That means he's my Oath Sworn now. And he's the only person I can use my ultimate on. And when I use my ultimate, I literally absorb him in, and then he chooses where to go after that. All I do is suck him in, and that's that. So, oh, damn it. I missed that. I'm still trying to get used to autoing then queuing. Oh, Scion's ult going off somewhere. Let's go ahead and boop, boop. Oh, God, that missed. Damn it. It's okay. It's okay. Ow. Not going to hit me with that spear, son. But when you and your Oathsworn both attack the same target, it does increased damage. What? Why? Ooh, that is interesting. Okay, so apparently we just learned something. Sebastien says that if you have your rend on anybody, and then you hit something that is in your range and use your rend on it, which is your E, it will do the damage regardless of range, and that will not be a kill, but we can still get some good damage off here. I'm gonna go ahead and just absorb him in here, and boom! This'll be boop! And Sebastien will pick up that kill, no problem. So easy money, absorbing him in there and pulling him in for the dive for a very, very simple dive, and that will be... Oh. Not do enough damage yet. But that will be the end of that dive, and this will be the end of this tower as well. So, boop, gonna go ahead and take that. Let's go ahead and just chuck my spears straight through them all, and I can actually go back and get my full Infinity Edge. So, 10-minute IE, and we do have... We aren't CSing amazingly, especially not as well as I should be with this lead. But we're still doing all right. And since I do still have... since I do still have 7 kills and 2 assists, like, that's really making up for any CS I would be missing right now overall. And my 2 deaths aren't helping either, but that's okay. It happens. Anyways, finishing the Infinity Edge, gonna go for Berserker Grease next. And sorry, guys, there is so much to this champion. I'm trying to think of everything I have and haven't said. Your ultimate, like I said, it sucks them in. It makes them untargetable and pacified. And they can choose to be thrown wherever. And anything they hit, I think it's any champions, or is it just anything they hit? First enemy champion hit, it knocks them up when he hits them. So that's some good stuff to know. So, ow, jerk. She hit me with that Q. Alright. Pew! Gonna nail, oh my goodness. Bam! Oh, so it actually does work like that. Nice. So I can actually just run up here and boop, gonna Q her, and Thresh is gonna go for... Oh, shit. Alright. Maybe? Oh, what? There's a victor there! Fuck! Alright. The victor came and kind of wrecked me. Alright, let's see. AP Tristana going to be able to burst with the resets. Come on. Come on, man up, man up, man up. Here it is, man up. There is one! There's the kick out, and oh, he's stunned. Will he be able to jump out? Oh, he's jumping in, and he will get a kill right there, and it looks like Sion trying to do stuff. The ultimate coming out from Sion, but Sion does, like, no damage and tried to flash away, but he was inside the minions. So, will not be finding success here. Will actually be getting 4-man ganked, and I messed up. I truly messed up that one. I didn't see that they were going to go in on me. I did see that Sebastien said he was warding, but I didn't think they would go in on me for some reason or another. But they did, and they did a good job going in on me right at that time. And then they, at the same time, they just 4-man ganked me, and, you know, as you guys know, that wasn't very cool. So let's go ahead, bam, boom, boom, kill right there. Let's go ahead and just E away, and whoop, and oh, there's the double kill. Keep the kite. Let's go. Going back in, kind of waltzing our way in here. And let's go ahead and chuck Sebastien at them. The knockup. And, okay, no hook is going to land here. Let's go ahead and do some damage. Boom. Bam. Wait. All right. Okay, I'm out. Am I out? All right. So I'm out. The jump right there from Tristana, though, will not land. Now let's see. Come on. Oh, the buster shot going to land right there. And maybe... Damn it. Wait. Damn it. I was wondering if, I don't know. I haven't supported a Kalista yet, so I don't know if it's right-click or left-click. Anyways, overall, we did some, good plays there. And maybe if I was a bit more seasoned with this champion, I could have done better. But still, she feels awkward for me right now. This is only my second game ever playing her. But I think I've gotten everything out of the way. Oh, wait. One other thing. Your boots? The tier of your boots actually makes you jump further. I think it scales off of your movement speed or something like that. Is it your movement speed or just boots? Yeah, it's just boots. So if you have tier 2 boots, it'll go further than tier 1. And tier 1 will go further than no boots. So, pretty simple concept. But we picked up our zeal on that back. I will be going for the static shiv. Because apparently there are 2 good builds right now on Kalista, as far as I can tell. You have your Infinity Edge into Static Shiv build, and then you have with the maxing Q, mind you. And then you have the other build where people rush Bork into Shiv, and then they max their E. So let's go ahead and just try and do this dragon here. Boop, boop. Because this shouldn't be too hard for us. Especially since Kalista effectively has her own smite, which is ridiculous. So let's go ahead and just make sure I get that. Easy peasy. And the reason that worked is simply because Kalista's E does so much damage. Unless you weren't there as Kalista, you pretty much can't outsmite her. It's insane. Especially when you're doing the Bork maxing E build, there's pretty much no chance of outsmiting her. Because her E does more damage than Smite does after you get some good auto attacks in there. I've seen people gain up to like 50 stacks or more on Baron, and then they do freaking like 2,000 damage onto the Baron itself with just activating her E. So it's insane. So as you guys saw, I did exactly that there. I secured it with using my E. I'm going to go ahead and take this blue as well. And let's see if we can get this Akali. So it looks like our mid Tristana is doing pretty well. She has her DFG completed. Looks like Sebastien going to go in there. Bam! This'll be some boom! Good damage. And boink. And oh, let's go ahead and... What? My ult didn't go. Does it have like a charge up time? Does it have like a charge up time? I tried to use my ultimate to save Sebastien, but I guess it takes a second to like yank him in. So maybe I was just late. I don't know. All I know is that I tried to use it to save him and I didn't get him. So sadly, I wasn't able to save Sebastian's life like I planned, but we did still pick up the kill and we are still going to get this top tower, though it could have been much smoother. So hopefully Sebastien sees this and hears my apology. But I'm going to go get red myself here, and I can actually get my full shiv right now. And after that, maybe since they don't have a lot of armor yet, I could go for, what could I go for? I could go for Last Whisper. So, or not Last Whisper, but Bloodthirster, since they don't have much armor. And I can do tons of more damage. Or I could go for Yomu's even. Yomu's is apparently pretty good on her too. Depending on what you do. I think it's better if you go Bork with the Yomu's, but I know it's a very viable method. So let's go ahead and just boop, boop, kill all this shit. And whoa, looks like this Lee Sin's pretty low. Little does he know, though, that he will not be getting away from this. Go, my little sentry. Go. Spot him. Spot him. It didn't spot him. Boop. Okay, I don't think I hit him there. Where the hell did Lee go? Where'd he go? This is rigged. This is rigged, alright. Oh, my sentries have spotted some targets. And there it goes. Oh, the Nami ult. Let's go ahead and fucking flash in here. Boom, this'll be some good damage in here. Boom, there's one kill. Dodge out on that. Boom, boom, boom. Two kills right there. And boom, triple kill. Let's go ahead and see if we can get more. And come on. Quad. Wait. No. No. Where'd she go? Where'd she go? No, I'm not in range. Son of a bitch. Fuck. That was my chance to get a pinata. Damn it. It was so close. All right. Let's see. Let's see. Oh. He knows. He knows. That kind of stinks, though. Anyways. Still got a good triple kill in there, and I'm able to go back now with... Oh, shit! This isn't good! Huh. Well, that was warded. So, they had that warded. Thresh actually came back up and just wrecked me with a hook and the Lee Sin Q at the same time. So, I mean, that kind of stinks that I died there, but now I at least have Shiv and another BF sword. So we are much bigger now. Shiv and BF complete on one back. Let's go, boys. So I'm really... It's really hard to commentate when I'm trying to focus more on playing this champion, because she's so goddamn fun. So I do apologize if I'm not being as informative for you guys as I would like to. But hopefully you are getting the gist of the champion and how I tend to use her. Uh-oh, Tristana could be in a pickle. Oh, yep. She is definitely in a pickle. She just got shrecked. All right, I'm coming in. Kalista's here. Kalista's here, boys. All right, let's see. The hook will not land, and the Scion Q will also not land, but let's go ahead and pow. Did I hit him? I did hit him. I wonder how much damage I did. So, let's see. It looks like Baron's up. So, let's get the Scuttle Crab real fast. Boink. Boink. All right. Now we got the Scuttle Crab, so we can actually take a... Whoa! This isn't... Oh, shit! This isn't good at all! How did that hook? That was a hella long and good hook. That shit on me. Holy nips. All right. Looks like Husky, though, and in, though. The big ultimate from Vlad coming out. And he flashed out. You wuss. You wuss. Oh my gosh. Alright, it's okay though. It's okay. Oh, wait. Is that going to be Tristana kill? It looks like... yeah, it will. Ooh. Barely gonna live to 10 HP right there. Alright, alright. I'll stop being hella cocky. I need to stop being as cocky as I am being because it is definitely getting me killed right now. But we can still definitely make the plays. I feel the plays. I feel the plays entering my bones. Let's go ahead and look at their builds again. It looks like no armor, very minuscule amounts of armor, no armor, no armor, no armor. So, me going for this BFBT second big item, other than Shiv, I guess, so third big item, is actually not a bad choice. And as you guys can see, now that I've gotten more attack speed, it is easier for me to do the last hitting and jump around more often. So that's kind of what I was like counting on right there. Because when you get more attack speed... Oh, they did that fast. They did that very fast. But as I get more attack speed, it gets a lot easier for me to jump around in shorter time. And then essentially do more work. So let's go ahead and drop our little sentinel dude over here. So if anyone comes over that way, they will be spotted. And, oh, hello. All right, looks like Sebastien going in over here, maybe. All right, so get out of here, bitch. That's my sentinel. Take a little chunk of your HP, son. All right, let's see. Are they doing this blue? They totally are. Whoa! Alright, looks like... Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and suck him in with this ultimate. And boom! This'll be some big damage coming out there. Saving Sebastien and getting him into that fray. Holy shit, the burst! They just got so dunder biffed. And that will be... Definitely should be a Baron for us, actually. So... absolutely wrecking them. Sebastien with an amazing bait, actually, busting quite a lot of their spells onto him, and that was enough to get, like, all of them killed. So let's see. Uh-oh. Whoa! That knock-up! Holy shit! That really got me up there. Alright, this is, looking iffy, but we got this, boys. We got this. Alright, looks like Lee Sin coming in here. Let's go ahead and BAM! That will be the Baron for Kalista, using my Ren to get it, making sure Lee Sin ain't gonna steal it. And I kinda wanna kill this Scuttle Crab. Oh no! Damn it. Alright, that happens though, it's okay. So my ultimate's back up in very few seconds. 5S till ult. Cause I think with my ultimate, we could definitely wreck them. If they come for us. If they don't come for us, that's not something I wanna sit there and go for myself. That just sounds like a tremendously bad idea to go shoving after it. But now that I have my Bloodthirster, Last Whisper will be next, and then we will see where we go from there. Maybe a Bork could be still beneficial for me, but not at the moment. Oh, whoa! AP Trizana showing what she does, and that will be definitely a kill. Boom! Wait, what? I missed. Hey. Oh, wait. Nami wave and... Alright. Boop! And boom! Pulling him into range there with my flash will be easy money. And we even got Victor's flash too. So that'll be a very dead Victor. And some spears going out for me. But we will just be kind of waltzing towards him. And now we get the inhibitor. So pushing with this Baron, as you guys can see, actually they changed Baron buff and Dragon. So Baron buffs your minions when you're around it, along with a big combat buff for you. But then Dragon will, yeah, what Sebastien just said. What it does, or what Baron does, is makes your minion super buff. And as you guys may have been able to see there, you can actually have a siege minion attacking towers from outside of tower range. So it makes sieging really easy. And it makes it by far the best option. So we'll just be able to protect this next siege minion. It looks like, wait, does he want to go in? I don't know. I'm going to make sure I don't get thresh hooked, though, because that doesn't sound very good. Let's go ahead and drop this here. Oh, the hook coming out on him. And bam, boom. All right, we got some big damage coming out here. Not enough, though. Whoa, she is definitely dead. So let's go ahead and just yoink, yoink. And pulling in Sebastien here. We'll be getting them with the ultimate. So boom, Kalista is not going to live, and neither is Thresh. So the double kill coming out. Sebastien just hurtling himself into the enemies. We will take them down. Easy peasy once again. So let's go ahead and get this turret here. And if Leeson wants to come towards me, I am down to throw some fisticuffs. So come here, Lee. Whoop, you can't hit me. Come on, son. You can't hit this. So let's go ahead and just kill this inhibitor for style points. And I said style points. I said style points, Kalista. Thank you. So let's see. Whoa, looks like Scion ultimate coming out. And oh, shit. This is... Ooh! Wow-wee! They definitely all piled onto me right there. But the AP Tristana, ladies and gentlemen, they stacked up at the wrong time. Will be the rest of my team dunking them so horribly. And let's go ahead and... Damn it, I was hoping to buy Zonias for fun there. But that will be a great Kalista game, ladies and gentlemen. The double Nexus explosion into the victory. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you like it, very builds me up. If you want to, you can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, or my second YouTube channel. All four links will be in the description below. And as always, I love you guys. I hope you have a wonderful day. Peace!